Our Google Spreadsheets integration adds a proper way of reorganizing your information in clean and functional pages. This integration allows your bot to send and receive data from a spreadsheet, keeping it organized and safe in your Google account. Great, let's get into it. So we'll divide this video in three sections. First, the placement, configuration, and different available actions to perform with an example and the possible outcomes. Up next, the Google Sheet integration dashboard inside Landbot. And finally, we'll answer some frequently asked questions. So to start us off, placement and configuration of the block. A crucial thing to know is that for the Google Sheet to recollect information, it has to be placed after your information has been gathered, letting it send everything to your spreadsheet. When the block is created, you'll see the options to add or select an account. Now, head over to docs.google/spreadsheets. Create a new document with your chosen name. Customize your sheet name, because it will be less confusing when setting up the block. Create the rows that will fit in the variables saved in your bot. In this case, we'll create the row ID, name, email, phone number, and country. This way, we'll have the information ready to use and organized. Go back to your bot, select the spreadsheet you've just created, and select the specific sheet where the information will be written. Let's now get into the block's different actions and outputs, and then an example for each one of them. The three actions we have are insert a new row, update a row, and get data from a row. Let's start with insert a new row. Inserting a new row means that you'll be adding a cell of information in your document. To start this off, we have these question blocks asking the user's basic information, like name, email, country, and phone number. Now for the spreadsheets block. When this action is selected, you'll have to choose the column where the information will be added. In this case, the column name. For this, we have to select the variable that the bot will use to add a row, in this case, add name, and add another row that will be the email with the variable email. Press apply. Add a text block after the spreadsheets block with something like great. And let's see how the Google Sheet changes when the user reaches the block. Later in the video, we'll talk about the different outputs of the block. Here, I'll type something like Nick. Now, for the email, nick@test.com. And as you can see here, the information has been written on the spreadsheets. Cool, let's move into the next one. Update a row. Before entering the next action the block can do, let's add a buttons block after the last Google Spreadsheets block, asking if their email is correct. The yes path will lead to a message like great, and the red path will lead to a new question email block, then to a spreadsheets block. Inside the spreadsheets block, when this option is selected, two new sections will open up. First, the reference column, which is the column that will be located by the bot. Here, we'll select the ID and the variable @ID. Then, the update in and by section is what information will be updated using the previous chosen column, where we will choose the email column with the @email variable. Press apply, and let's see how the bot updates the spreadsheet. Save, and let's preview it. So, here, my name, Nick, my email, wrongly written. Click on no, because this is not my email. My email again, well written. And this is how the spreadsheet updates it. Great, now let's move into the last option, get data from a sheet. For this example, we'll use a way to show the different job offers using the data from a spreadsheet's document. Let's start with a new bot. First, customize your welcome message with something like, welcome to our job offers. Then, add a buttons block with the buttons assistant manager, receptionist, and intern. Now, we create the variable @jobOfferTitle inside the buttons block. Create a Google Spreadsheets block from the default output of your buttons block. Let's keep building the bot. We'll configure the spreadsheets block later on. Now, add a series of buttons block that will match our columns in the spreadsheets document. Let's name this @message1 with brackets, @message2, etc. Once done, let's create our spreadsheets document. Set it up like this. Nice. Let's finish this up by configuring our Google Spreadsheets block inside Landbot. Select the sheet we've just created. Now, the action to perform, in this case, get data. In the reference column, we'll write add job offers title associated to its variable. And in get value, select the different variables you created with the messages. So add message one, add message two, etc. Press save and let's preview the bot. Let's select enter. And now the bot has gathered the information from the document and is giving us a job description for the intern spot in the company. Now, let's understand when the paths of the spreadsheets block will be triggered. The green path will be taken whenever the action has been completed successfully. On the other hand, the red path will be chosen when something has gone wrong and the action has been interrupted. That's why we recommend you connecting the red path to another block. If it's not done, the bot will stop if the information has not been gathered correctly. Next up, the integrations dashboard. Go to integrations, located in the left part of your screen. Look for the Google Sheet integration and click on it. Here, you can manage the different Google accounts you have linked with Landbot and access your error logs to see where and when your users have triggered the red path throughout your bots. Let's get into some of the most frequently asked questions. Thank you. Can I use two Google Sheet blocks, one right after the other? There needs to be at least one other block between them, and that's because the Google Spreadsheets block receives information in real time from your bot while your flow is happening. If we put two Spreadsheets blocks side by side, Landbot would not be able to send the information and would make your bot stop suddenly. Next question. What happens if I search for a value in a column, but the value doesn't exist? If no value is found, it will go through the red path. Make sure to connect this path to another block. If you don't, the flow will stop. Next question. What would happen if there were two or more cells with the same value? The integration only returns values from one row. In this case, it would return the value that is higher up in the spreadsheet. Great, so we've gone through a lot of things, so let's recap. We've seen the placement and configuration of the block, then the different available actions to perform with an example and the possible outcomes. After that, the Google Sheet integration dashboard inside Landbot. And lastly, some frequently asked questions. So that's all. Hope this was helpful, and I'll see you in the next one.